For over a year, we tried to persuade the Soviet authorities to show us the relics of their moon program. They finally agreed, and we were taken to an old hangar, a kind of space junkyard. Mishin gave us a guided tour of his original lunar hardware. This was the command module which might have flown around the moon. It's modeled on the Soyuz craft and has a hatch from which a cosmonaut would walk across open space to the lunar lander. If the N1 rocket had worked, the legs of this lander might be resting where they belong, in moon dust.
Лунное посадочное устройство состоит из четырех вот таких вот пят, которые, значит, вонзаются как бы в поверхность Луны, и вот этих вот амортизаторов, которые амортизируют удар, если такой будет, при посадке. Далее космонавт при помощи специального люка опускается на вот эту площадку, и вот при помощи вот этой лестницы спускается на поверхность Луны. После пребывания на поверхности Луны космонавт вновь возвращается в лунную кабину.
No one in the West has ever seen inside the Soviet lunar lander. So what secrets would it reveal? This was where the intrepid cosmonaut would stand, clutching two levers. It looked more like the inside of a steam train than a spaceship. Even allowing for the Spartan appearance of Soviet hardware, these systems looked surprisingly primitive.